He's an Emmy award-winning actor. He's been in movies such as Overboard, The Great Gatsby, and he's also known as Richard Gilmore on the TV show Gilmore Girls. He has narrated numerous audiobooks, including Unbroken by Laura Hillenbrand, and I'm joined by Edward Herrmann. Hi, Edward. How are you today?
Good morning. How are you, Brynn?
I'm great. So thank you for coming on the program. And how did you move from starring in shows like Gilmore Girls and movies like Overboard to narrating for audiobooks?
Well, it started a long time ago, and frankly, I don't remember the first book I was asked to narrate. I started in the theaters. Word has always been very important to me. And I just found over the years that I love telling stories and I love recorded books. So it's been a very happy marriage.
Now, you said you don't remember the first one that you narrated, but what would you say is your favorite one that you've narrated?
Oh, I've been doing it for quite a number of years. I've had a lot of favorites. Some of Ayn Rand's books, Atlas Shrugged. I've loved David McCulloch's book, John Adams. I just finished two wonderful books, The Unbroken by Laura Hillenbrand and Roger Ebert's memoir about his struggles and triumphs. And I've just had an awfully good time.
And what kinds of rewards do you get from working on all of this?
Well, besides the monetary rewards, which are slender when you compare them to a television show or a film, the reward is that you're in control of the whole process if you're doing a single narration, and you get to paint the picture you want without a lot of intrusion. You can create the characters and create the scene and enliven the text the way you wish it should be done. And sometimes when you're working with a director that you have differences with or other actors that you're struggling to make something work, you wish you could do it all by yourself. And sometimes you can't, especially when you're recording a book.
And I would imagine, because your voice is your instrument for something like this, that it would take a lot of time to get it just right. So about how long does it take you, on average, to record one of these books?
Well, it depends on the size of the book, of course. Sometimes I just finished helping one of a number of readers that we recorded the King James Version of the Bible. And that takes quite a while. But if we are doing a Dr. Seuss story, that can take an afternoon. I just finished a little piece for Stephen King, a short story by Stephen King. The whole trick of it is to adapt your voice and your attitude and your mind to the quality of the book. Each book has a certain sound, a certain direction, a certain attitude, and the trick is to find that and then adapt it adapt your voice to it, so that you don't read a serious book with a comic voice, and hopefully you don't read comedy with a serious voice. So it's a question of just like acting on stage or in front of a camera, it's finding the right voice and finding the right character.
So there's a lot of research that goes into this.
Well, you certainly have to read the book and think about it a good deal before you record. Some people think that you just sit down and read it cold, which isn't the fact. I mean, you folks in radio have to do that a lot, and I admire it because it's very difficult to do. It's also hard work. I'm sure people think that you just sit there and chit-chat and you know, you're sitting down and you don't really work hard, but I tell you, announcers work very hard, and I'm a great admirer of that.
Right. I was once told that radio is theater of the mind, and I can imagine it's the same for you.
I think so. You use people's imaginations. I grew up in a household where we didn't have a television until I was about 10, so our generation may be the last that was read to by our mothers and fathers, and we listened to the radio, and you used your imagination to see the pictures that they were creating with words. And I think that's one of the attractions of audiobooks. People miss that. People miss being read to. And then you're driving down the highway with in your little cocoon of a car, and you have one voice coming out of the radio with a story, and they're speaking just to you, and it's intimate and kind of reassuring. It's nice. People like that feeling. I think that's one of the reasons audiobooks are so popular now.
Now, do you think that the sale of the paperback and the hardback books is still increasing, or with the technology of e-readers and audiobooks, do you think it's decreasing a little bit?
I'm not sure. That's a very good question. I haven't seen the figures on it. I do know that in publishing now for a major release, they like to get the recorded before the hardback and paperback hit the stands. So they're covering their bases all the way around. I think audiobooks are beginning to have a real impact on the sale of a story. So I couldn't give you a factual answer on that one. I don't know.
And
I suspect it is, though.
And I also wanted to ask you about your on-screen career. You've had numerous projects that you've worked on, from Overboard mm-hmm. to Gilmore Girls to The Great Gatsby. What would you say was your favorite?
Oh, there's so many. Overboard was an awful lot of fun. Kurt and Goldie were falling in love, and it was a goofy, funny script, and we would sometimes have to wait for them because they were down below in the boat, you know, enjoying each other's company, and we'd have to wait till they got back up. But the Gilmore Girls was enormous fun because it was such a talented cast. Lauren Graham is so funny and charming, and Kelly Bishop and Alexis Bledel were all still in touch with each other. I just finished an episode of The Good Wife just last week, and that was terrific. I love that show. It's a great cast. So, gosh, if I started listing all the fun times I've had, we'd be here for about 3 days.
And I feel like on Gilmore Girls, you basically watch Alexis Bledel grow up. So what was that like?
It was very touching because she came to the show with having a modeling experience. Very, very intelligent girl, but no acting experience. And she was thrown into the cauldron of a single camera, 1 hour show with scripts that were 75 and 80 pages long, which is the length of a major feature film. And we had to do it in 1 hour. And a one-hour show, as you know, but most people don't, it's only 46 minutes of recorded material, of filmed stuff. So we had to talk a mile a minute, and it was very difficult dialogue. And she had trouble in the first year, 2 years. And I was in a position as a kind of veteran actor to hold her hand a little bit and talk to her about it and tell her what a wonderful profession it is, and she said, "I don't know what to do with it." It was tough on her, but she rounded the corner and became a wonderful professional. She's just been a terrific girl. It's tough, you know. It was gratifying to see her blossom during that show. She became very much the professional.
Wow! So you basically became a mentor to her throughout that show.
Well, I don't want to overemphasize my role in it. Lauren helped, and her own pluck and wit and strength of character did it too. But I'm happy to say that I don't think I made it more difficult for her. I tried to give her some perspective on what kind of a life the theater can be, and that it can be positive. It isn't all 1 hour television. It's theater, and she's since been on stage, and she's doing just fine.
And you were also in the original, The Great Gatsby, and it's now being remade starring Leonardo DiCaprio. Are you excited to see this new interpretation of the movie?
I am. It's a wonderful book. This will be the third version that I know of. There was a version made in the 40s with Alan Ladd at Paramount. And then there was Jack Clayton, who directed the second one with Bob Redford. And it's such a complex and beautiful book that it can take another interpretation. And I greatly admire Leo because I did the Aviator with him. I had a nice scene with him in that. And I think he's a serious and admirable actor, a very intelligent guy. And I think I'm really anxious to see what he does with it.
Well, thank you, Edward, for coming on the program, and have a great day. That was Edward Herrmann. He's an Emmy award-winning actor from movies such as Overboard and The Great Gatsby, and he also has played Richard Gilmore in the hit show Gilmore Girls.